Third time's a charm, but for only one team. Dick and I'll find out which team continues on their quest for a championship after today's third round game between the Duke Blue Devils and the Kentucky Wildcats.
It's showtime, baby. Let's skip the intros and get this one started.
You got it, partner. So without any further delay, let's get this one started. The Wildcats know this isn't going to be an easy one. What's the key for them tonight, Dick?
Hey, the keys for them tonight are simple. First of all, don't allow any good looks from behind the arc. Challenge every shot. Second of all, reward your big men for running the court. Get them some easy buckets in transition. And finally, keep it simple defensively and play as a unit.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. That comes off. Might have been some contact on the shot. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first, initially, he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebounding position, a good block out. And that's essential in a post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
There's the pick. They'll work it around the arc. There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
Let's see if they can get him the ball.
This is what you're supposed to do down low. He got the bucket to go, and he'll have the chance to add one more.
He saw the foul coming, Brad, but he got it up anyway.
They will line him up. He sinks it. Going to move it around the perimeter. High post flashes. He's got some room. There's the pick. There's the roll. Shows patience waiting for the reset.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
He gets the rejection. And the ball goes out of bounds. Full house. And a packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Number three is feeling good.
Well, you know, Brad, these student athletes play with fire and emotion. You rarely see that in the pros.
Tries for two. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Number 25 handles the feed. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad foul right there, Brad.
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
The dribble, gives it up, executes the baby hook.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position, and then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking the shot when you make that turn.
Inside. Number 54 with the fake. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer. Look at that spacing.
Inside. For the bucket. Can't get the shot to drop. Trying to pack it inside.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball to the deck. Where's he going?
Fakes the jumper. The shooting guard receives the pass. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Fed the low block. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot. Footwork, to me, that's all rebounding is. Get your body between the hoop and your man and block out.
The center receives the ball. Controlling the ball. Way off target. Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Worked the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
There was no doubt about that one. He shoots from the top of the circle. He drains the trifecta.
Let's go to the videotape for that one.
Gave it up. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you gotta have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Duke are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they've put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
Had an open guy in the post and went the other way. He blocks the shot.
That was awesome, baby.
Doesn't go. Obvious foul. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
The ball goes out of play. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
Went away from the post and goes the other way. He goes with a jump hook. They've yet to put together a decent string of good looks at the basket.
Hey, they're getting frustrated and playing right into the defense's hand.
Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. He'll regroup the offense.
They say forget about it, and then he does a little dribbling act here and turns it over.
Looking for the foul. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Number 12 is pounded on his way up. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
Gets two at the charity stripe. He keeps the dribble as they reset. There's a bad pass right to the defender. Defensively down a low block, and there's a steal.
Terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
With a rejection. Steal. Fast break possibility coming. Takes it away. Here they come now on a turnover. Tries for two.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
Number 12 handles the pass. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can...
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
The skip pass is picked off. From downtown. Off the rim and no good. Looking for a good shot. looking for contact. Up, easy one. He pump fakes on the inside, leans in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity. And it really converts an offensive transition.
Okay, Dick, some people were predicting this. The players are starting to taunt one another. Number 21 steps to the line for the first time. He gets it to go. A wide open look. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
On the dribble, gives it up. Picked out of the air. They run it up into transition for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Dick, he's going to go up strong.
Oh, that's a terrific post play. Didn't waste any time attacking the basket. I like it when a team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
Both free throws go. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
Number 32. He takes the hard hack in the air, but he lays the ball in.
That's what you take for the team, Brad.
He steps up to the line. You can't miss free throws, Dick. It's going to kill you somewhere down the line.
Well, you got to convert. That's the one thing, like football, special situations. You got to be able to execute there.
Boy, terrible execution on offense. He was doing a great job pressuring the ball and decided to go for the steal. A questionable decision, though, on his part because it resulted in a foul.
That's why some coaches don't like it when players go for the steal. They end up with fouls or in foul trouble.
Lobs it. The shot from the baseline. Way off target.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important on how talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
Beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
And the ball goes out of play. For the bucket and off the mark. Work the perimeter. Now the high screen. He takes the shot from the baseline. Off the rim and no good. Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside though is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
Whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. Goes up for two. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
Pass down low. There's a drop step. And, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Tries for two. Can't get the shot to go.
Post screen
for two. Duke have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad.
I think he's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball in there. High post screen. So effective that screen.
Lazy pass. And a momentary look from three-point land. He intercepts it. Launches the three. Way off target. They work it around the perimeter. Gave it up. There's the rejection. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
Up for two.
He used the screen beautifully to free himself for the easy deuce. That was a great, great effort right there, trying to play that passing lane, anticipating really well.
He's got a high post flasher. And that's going to be an offensive foul for sure.
What a great job defensively. What a super job. Great footwork. And he really draws the charge.
Moving it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. And working around the perimeter. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Intercepted. In the paint. For two. Duke have put together somewhat of a run here.
Maintaining it is the key, though. They've got to continue to make the hustle plays at both ends of the court.
He went for the steal in the post, and he missed it, Dick.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. What a poor job defensively. He gambled.
Takes away the pass. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I'll tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
The shot fake. Here's a double team for the bucket. Perfectly executed. There they come with a double team to stop it. At halftime, the Wildcats trail by nine. Now let's rewind a little bit here and watch the play of the half. Kentucky turned the ball over quite a few times in that first half, Dick.
The heads just aren't in the game. Some of the turnovers were unforced and plain silly, if you ask me.
check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Goes up for two. He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know, he's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
For two. Drops the bucket despite the harm.
Step out on that screener.
The ball goes out of bounds. On the outside. On the dribble, gives it up.
Up and inside. Nice fake.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, do you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
Post flashes up high if he wants it. They've left him completely alone. Number 12 makes a great move to draw the foul. A chance for two. First one is good. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
Gets the second. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
The shooting guard takes the feed. Stolen away.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box. He kept the ball on the floor and waited for his teammate to set that screen for the sweet jumper. Boy, that was beautiful.
Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Wow, the defender got the worst of that hard screen.
Nice high post screen.
He shoots from the baseline. He gets another shot off and in.
Hey, this show's about to start, Brad.
Tries the turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Kicks it out.
There's the trap.
The Blue Devils have a mismatch in the post.
You're right, Brad. There is a mismatch.
He looks at the hoop. Tries to get the D to bite. He goes with a jump hook. And in and out. Thinks about the shot. Goes up for two. And he missed. Now they work it around the perimeter. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
They still don't score. Looking for a good shot. The ball goes out of play. Well, there's a turnover situation. I guess most notable, the number of points off turnover.
Well, Mr. Nestler, that's why you want to take care of the basketball. You want to protect it. Turnovers will result in points being scored at the other end. That's
swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
The power forward takes the pass. Jump hook from the low block. Rims out. Number 32 with the foul.
Shot was no good, baby. Beautiful use of the screen, though.
At the line. Routine. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Second shot is no good. Gets it. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Post flasher is open. Fakes it. He takes the shot from the baseline. The Wildcats have got to continue to get him the ball.
Brad, he's on fire.
They work the perimeter. Puts up the jumper. Sticks the deuce. Pump fakes. Tries for two. He sinks another basket. What are they going to do with this guy, Dick?
I don't know, Brad, but they better do it quickly.
He can't get the hoop to fall. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Perfectly executed.
That was awesome, baby.
With the fake, executes the baby hook.
I tell you, great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
And now they'll bring it up. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. They're working around the arc. Nicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Picked out of the air. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Steals the pass. Gave it up. Long down court pass. Here's a flash from the high post. He launches the bomb. He gets that one to fall.
That's a 7-zip run.
Picked off.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards up there.
Yeah, that helps. to the action. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle there.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
That was like a NASCAR wreck and no whistle.
Wow, no call. You like that NASCAR? Hey, where's Mr. Petty?
There's the fake.
Double team now, bad angle.
Another turnover.
And they're not talking out the turnovers either. Up and inside.
Picks off the pass. The shooting guard gets the pass. It sticks. Had him in the paint, but went elsewhere. Outside jumper, off the rim and no good. Moving it around the perimeter. Jumps in. Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad, as you can imagine, I am seeing a completely different attitude on the bench now than I did in the first half. The coaching staff and players, they just have looks of disbelief on their faces.
Thanks, Aaron. And one too many dribbles and a steal.
Look at speed. I tell you, man, there's nothing like having athleticism and quickness.
That kid's making him think about every shot, Dick.
And he's doing it without fouling, which is the key.
Looking for a good shot. He wants a three. Way off target. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position of spreading his body and getting the ball.
Off the pass. For two. Can't get the shot to drop. Shoots from the outside.
They're going to find a way to get some easy buckets to get their confidence back, Brad.
Absolutely. They got to get it going here. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job by the defense not allowing them to make that turn. That spacing.
Fakes the shot. Trying to draw the foul. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up from the baseline. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
Now they work it around the perimeter. The shot from the baseline.
He made good use of the screen, but the shot fell off.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Steals a pass. Gave it up. And the ball goes out of play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He throws it up from downtown.
Great screen set up, but the shot won't go.
Lobs it, jumps into the defender. Up, easy one. It might be safe just to start that bus up. I think this one's over.
It sure is, Brad. They have no chance of getting back into this one.
Can't get the shot to go. He goes for the trifecta. Off the rim and no good. Pushes it up. Picks off the lazy pass. Up fake. He tries a jump hook. Doesn't go. Tries for two. Off the rim and no good. He fires from long range. What should they do here, Dick?
I call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
He intercepts it. Trying to draw some contact. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
He goes to the line for the first time. Misses the first shot. Gets the second shot. Dribble, gives it up. There's a double team waiting there. He fires away.
Screen was there, but the shot didn't fall.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He comes up empty. Gave it up. Great defense. Pushes it. Long lead pass. For two. He puts it in with contact and all. Cross court. Had a momentary look from three-point land. They work the perimeter. Number 54 is pounded on his way up. You talk about a great drive. How about the State Farm drive of the game?
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up, up, and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
Number 54 goes to the line for the first time. First one is no good. Second one is good. Shot clock is dead. Looking for a good shot. Working it around the perimeter. Looking for a screen on top and got it. Moving it around the perimeter. Stolen ball. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Rims out. Dick, you've said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, I'll tell you what, this game, Brad, when you looked at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Duke makes it three in a row with an impressive third-round victory.
Hey, the way they're playing, Brad, this team is going to be hard to deal with entering the Elite Eight.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.